Station. This is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston, we're ready for the event.
The Weather Channel. This is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is Ari Sarsalari with weather.com and the Weather Channel. How do you hear me?
Ari, we hear you loud and clear. Welcome to the International Space Station.
Thank you so much. It's really awesome to be with you guys. I appreciate the time. I'm a meteorologist. There are a lot of meteorologists here at the Weather Channel. Very often we look outside the window. We're big enthusiasts about the weather, and we see these amazing things, but I can't imagine what it has to look like being able to actually see this stuff from above. What would you guys say have been some of the more stunning things that you've seen? We can talk about, hurricanes, fires, maybe that you can see from space, lightning, thunderstorms, volcanoes, things like that.
So Ari, this is my first flight, and so looking out the window, this was the first time I got to see weather at a global scale. On the ground, you see the things that affect you, and this was a chance to see it unfold below me. And probably the most striking thing that hit me the first time was watching a thunderstorm at night coming up over the west coast of the United States and seeing the lightning flashes just blanket the entire United States as far as you could see, and it seems like they were always going off somewhere, and just the scale of that was just mind-blowing.
Yeah, it always seems like, when you look at things on a satellite loop, they don't look that big, but every time I see a photo of something like a hurricane from the ISS, it just looks absolutely massive. Like, what is the difference in perspective? I'm sure you guys have seen something like a visible satellite loop, like GOES 16 or GOES 17 or something like that. What is the difference in perspective when you're actually above it and you're looking at it with your eyes? Did we lose them?
I think that the biggest difference, Ari, is that. Sorry about that. Yeah. This must be my first flight, and it's not. The biggest difference is that weather satellites are very high, much higher than we are, and they have no humans inside. And on the International Space Station, what you get at 250 miles or 400 kilometers is exactly that, the human perspective, the human scale. Our horizon is about 6,000 kilometers, and so it's something a human can comprehend. So when I look at the Mediterranean, being European, and I can see all of the Mediterranean at once, it's impressive because I can place myself on that location. When Nick talks about the United States, that's where he's at, and you can see it with it at once, just out the window. So I think that's the biggest difference and why it's so impressive watching it from up here.
So since you guys have been up there, have you learned anything about the weather from space that you feel like meteorologists maybe down here on Earth still don't understand? Have there been any unique perspectives that have allowed you to actually learn anything new about the weather?
One of the things that struck me, the time that I spend looking out the cupola, is that this perspective that has kind of developed that the Earth is alive. All of these processes, we see them unfold underneath us, and we're constantly going around the globe and seeing these storms and the clouds flow and change, and you just get this sense from here that the Earth is alive. The other thing is that it's it's got this peaceful elegance to it at this distance. You know, you might have a terrible storm on the ground, be in the middle of a hurricane, and the winds are raging. But if you look at it from up here, it's got this structure, and it's quiet and serene, and it's just has this elegance to it. And it's that difference. It's really striking.
So when you guys decided to go into this field, you know, I know some people decide really young when they're a kid that they want to be an astronaut. Some people kind of find themselves in it along their career path. What was it that really, you know, kind of fired you up about getting into this? Was it the moon landing? Was it the, you know, the idea that you could get up into space and look down at the Earth? You know, were you trying to get to Mars? I mean, what really got you going with this stuff?
Well, I can only speak for myself. As a child in Italy or in Sicily, where I'm from, being an astronaut was definitely not a project. It was a dream, an absolute dream. What made me dream about it, as all the dreams, is that we desire what we see. Back in the 80s, when I was a young child, the space shuttle was flying for the first times, and even in Italy they were broadcasting the launches, and I remember seeing those astronauts in their white suits floating outside the space shuttle, thinking that must have been the coolest thing possible. And of course the collective memory of the Apollo era, even though Nick and I were not even born at the time, we somehow remember it through the words and the images and the writings of those that witnessed it. And I, as a matter of fact, I wasn't aware that man was not on the moon until much later. I must have been in my early teens when I realized, wait a second, we are going to space with a space shuttle, but we are not on the moon. And as a matter of fact, I still have people that think that I'm flying to the moon, which, you know, I would hate to disappoint them, so...
So I'm curious whether you've had any weather training in your, you know, kind of your journey to becoming an astronaut. I know at least for us, for meteorologists, everybody thinks that we are astronomers also. You know, you kind of become the token scientist wherever you're working, and everybody's always asking you about space, and I'm like, I don't know, I got to go look this up on Google or something. But do you guys have any actual weather training before you go up?
You know, that's one of the amazing parts of spaceflight is all the preparation leading up to the flight itself. We spend years getting trained on just this wide spectrum of subjects, you know, from medicine and geology, and there's even meteorology in there as well, though it's a little bit. And it's really so that we can try to help share the perspective of what we're seeing up here, and we can try to understand what's playing out below us when we do look out the window, and have that appreciation for it. It's a true privilege to be able to be a student in all of those different areas, and then come up here and try to put it all together.
One thing I've always wondered myself is what's more intense, the acceleration of when you're blasting off into space, or is it more intense when you're actually going through reentry, coming back to Earth?
Well, we have an expert here because he managed to do those things in the same day. But as far as I can, as far as I'm concerned, so far I've had two launches and one reentry, and I wouldn't even try to compare them. It's two different experiences. First of all, when you're launching on the Soyuz, it's very smooth, and you're focusing on the process and on getting into orbit, and then it's the starting on the voyage. When you're coming back, the accelerations are definitely higher, especially if you've been on the space station for 6 months. It's a lot harder on your body, but it's a completely different experience because you're going home, you're excited for different reasons. So, you know, I never put things in ranks, and I wouldn't try to compare those two experiences. They're just wonderfully different and exciting for different reasons.
I know Nick was talking about this earlier with the thunderstorms in particular that he saw, I think, off the West Coast. that looked really awesome at night. But for you, Luca, what was the one weather event that you'll never forget seeing from space?
So I remember a lot of events, but one that struck me for its devastation was a flooding in South Asia that I was asked to document. I had a bunch of different lenses prepped in cupola, and I was waiting for a specific angle of the sun so that in the sunglint, you can tell which ones are the normal waters. You can see the rivers that are darker, and then you see all the flood water. And when I took those pictures, I realized that the flooding had been massive. We were talking about areas the size of entire states. And I think that was the moment when I really became sensitized into climate change and what is happening. Through the past 6 years since my first flight, I've been able to watch other pictures from my colleagues, and the intensifying destroying capabilities of the events has been obvious to me through the pictures of my classmates and colleagues, and that's what I'm trying to figure out with my pictures this time as well.
Okay. So we do have some weather that's going on kind of right now. Do you guys ever actually like aid the National Hurricane Center or any of the weather agencies with their forecasting? Because you guys have a pretty unique perspective. Maybe you can see different changes that they can't see. Is there any aspect of that or no?
You know, Ari, NASA does have a large role in helping to feed information into that forecasting. But from the space station, our role is principally we get involved in the kind of the aftermath of the storms, being able to document what has happened and collect imagery so that people can go in and provide assistance where it's needed most. And that's essentially the focus of how we get involved in that that continuity of operations.
Well, you guys have a safe trip.
Something that happened. I was going to add that a couple of years ago, when there was a terrible fire in California, we were actually able to document in real time where the fire line and where it was moving, and those pictures were downloaded as fast as possible and sent to the California firefighters in order to give them a chance to react more quickly. So we are involved in all kinds of events where we can try to help with our positioning and our quick downloading of the pictures.
That's really great stuff. I'm very jealous of your guys' job. Once in a while, I look up in the sky, and I'm like, oh, that's probably the ISS. So I'll know who's up there now, and I really appreciate all you do. And safe trip, and thank you so much again for the time. I really appreciate it.
Oh, thank you. It's our pleasure.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event.
Thank you to all participants from the Weather Channel, Station. We are now resuming operational audio communications.